The Oracle 12c rack, the startup sequence, clusterware startup sequence. In this video, we are going to discuss. There will be an 4 level of spans, daemons while starting that Oracle clusterware. And in this video, it's described each and every level of that clusterware process is where it is started and executing, and it describes all the level of process, and I will show you the real time what it is happening in the background. Okay, now we will move to especially I have prepared a document slide for you to present in a pleasant way, and hope you all liked this video once watching at this end. Okay, let's move on. I told you Oracle 12c rack cluster with startup sequence in detail. In this video, I have explored all the sequence parts. You can read this description, not that this tutorial will describe about startup sequence of Oracle 12c rack cluster which is installed on Linux platform, and also describe about Oracle cluster process and daemons in detail in this step-by-step cluster explanation, which Oracle flow follow to bring up the clusterware. Okay, 12c Oracle clusterware startup sequence. Oracle clusterware startup automatically when the rack node starts. Yes, when we have installed on the 2-node rack, once you start up the machine, this will be the Oracle clusterware process will be start up automatically. Provides CRSETL CRS-enable provider. If you enable that CRS, it will start that when the node will start. Startup sequence process turns through the different levels. In below figure, you can find how multiple levels startup process to startup full grid infrastructure stacks, also how the resources that clusterware manages. Okay, let's move on to next one. Okay. Go to see all the processes in brief, in details. Before that, what is clusterware rack? We should know, at least we should understand what is rack. Yeah, Oracle real application cluster known as Oracle rack uses Oracle clusterware as the infrastructure that binds multiple nodes that then operate as a single server. In an Oracle environment, Oracle clusterware monitors all Oracle components such as instances and listeners. If failure occurs, then Oracle cluster automatically attempts to reach the failed component and also redirect operation to surviving components. That means surviving node, which means one node gets failed or node eviction gets happened, that services will be redirected to surviving node, which means that is 2-node rack will be there. If any one node problem occurs, the services will be redirected to surviving nodes, say node 2. If it is 4-node rack, then should be fine. It will be redirected to which is master node asset, that there will be the services will be redirected. Okay, simply I have put in one architecture, a rack architecture. What is the rack architecture? It is here. Here it is configured for the 3-node rack. This picture is demonstrate that rack. Simply, what is clusterware rack? Let's move on. Well, Oracle Cluster Registry, OCR. What is OCR? Yeah, OCR is a file which maintains cluster configuration information about any cluster database within the cluster. The OCR contains information such as information about the cluster node list and instance to node mapping information. OSR also contain information about the cluster resource profiles for resources that you have customized. The OSR resides on the shared storage that is accessible by all the nodes in your cluster. Oracle ClusterWare can multiplex or maintain or multiple copies of the OSR, and Oracle recommends that you use the feature of the ensure high availability. Okay, you can see here the picture I have demonstrated. Put the picture, what is OSR, it is explained all about the OSR, and I have shown the OSR config local so backup location, OSR backup where it is located, that location also I have shared here, and also I have checked that OSR health check, OSR check, it is showing what is the, if it's any issues and our OSR will properly configure, it will say it's like, you can see here. Let's move. Oracle local registry, OLR, it will be stored at both the nodes, how many nodes are there, each and individual, every local nodes, it will be, that registry file will be located. So each node in a cluster has a local copy of the OSR called an Oracle Local Registry, OLR, which is created when Oracle ClusterWare is installed. Multiple processes on each node have simultaneous read and write access to the OLR particular to the node on which they reside. Whether Oracle ClusterWare is fully functional, by default OLR is located at CRS home, CData, that machine name, rack 01. This is a machine here, rack 01. Okay, I will exclusively, I have given the location for you guys easily can pick it up and understand. This is the OSR file, OLR file, and this is the location. You can get the location here. This is a command, OSR config local so backup location. Okay, next. Voting disk. What is voting disk? The voting disk manages node membership information. Yes, each and every node information will be stored in the voting disk. The shared disk will be accessed by all member of the nodes in the cluster. It is used in a central reference to all the nodes and keeps the heartbeat information between the nodes. If any of the nodes is unable to ping the voting disk, cluster immediately recognizes a communication failure, and this point it will happen the node eviction. Evict the node from the cluster. So where it will be the communication unable to heartbeat failure occur, the node eviction will be happen. Unable to access the voting disk. One node unable to access the voting disk, then it will be keep on trying for every 60 seconds and will be trying to evict the node from the cluster. Then we need to fix the issue. What is the issue? Why it's not getting that communication happened from the voting disk? Everything we need to dig into it. Okay, here is the simple picture I have explained to you guys for your understanding. Voting disk, how it is, this will be a shared disk, it will be accessed by all the nodes. Okay, well, move on. Here is the brief explanation of the 12 rack startup sequence. You can see here, guys, once the instance is also a rack, a node gets started, that init, it is executing OHASD and it will go to that ORR root agent, and as a CSD agent, simultaneously it is logging. I will show you, I am going to stop the ClusterWare process now, and I will show you this, how it will work. This is the picture, startup sequence picture. You can easily understand how it is that the rack startup, ClusterWare startup process is happening in the background. It's what is going on. You can see here is very well described here in the picture. You can easily understand what is going on in the rack startup. Let's move on. Okay, here it is. Once the operating system start and finish the boot up step process, it's DT etc init D file via the initialization daemon called or init D. The init tab file is one of the triggers Oracle High Availability Service daemon. Yes, you can see here the file cd etc init tab is there. No, this is init.d or actually .initd. Okay, you can go to the cat Oracle OHSD configuration file. You can see the explanation what is happening on this file. This init will call this file, init it will call to this file, and it, what is happening, start on run level 35, res respawn, execute init D init which is the run. So Oracle cluster development process getting started from here. This is the initiative file. This init file only will be starting the Oracle High Availability Service Daemon, OHASD startup. Okay. Number one, when a node on Oracle cluster starts, OHASD started a platform specific means initd and Linux, which is the root for bringing up the Oracle cluster where OHASD start has access to the OLR Oracle local SD stored in the local file system. OLR provides needed data to complete OHASD initialization. Number two, OHASD brings up GPNPD, grid plug and play daemon, and CSG, clusterware synchronous service daemon. CSG has access to GPNP, grid plug and play profile stored on the local file system. This profile contains the following via bootstrap data. Number one, ASM disk group discovering string. Number two, ASM SV file location disk group name. Number three, name of the ASM disk group containing of the voting files. Okay. Number three, the voting files location ASM disk are accessed by CSSD with well-known pointers in the ASM disk headers, and CSSD is able to complete initialization and start or join an existing cluster. Number four, OHASD starts an ASM instance and ASM can now operate with the CSSD initialization and operating. The ASM instance uses special code to locate the contents of the ASM SV file, assuming it's stored in your disk group. Number five, with an ASM instance operating under a disk group mounted, access to clusterware OCR is available to CRSD. Number 6, OHASD starts CRSD with access to the OCR in an ASM disk group. Number 7, clusterware completes initialization and brings up services under its control. Okay, hope you guys so far understanding what is, how it is happening, that clusterware processes. You can see here another picture demonstrate here for the 4 level of process spans, level 4 processes below, and we will see each and every levels in detailed manner. Next. Okay, level 1, OHASD spawn. What this will do, CSSD agent responsible for spawning CSSD, or our root agent responsible for managing all root owned OHASD resources, or our agent responsible for managing all Oracle owned OHASD resources, CSSD monitor. Monitor CSSD and node health along with the CSSD agent. So, level 1, what is happening? The OHASD start with the CSSD agent, or a root agent, or a agent, CSSD monitor. Okay. Number 2, level 2, OHASD root agent spawn. Root agent spawn. CRSD in this primary daemon responsible for managing cluster resources, CTSD, cluster time synchronous daemon, disk 1. ACFS, ASM cluster file system drivers. Number 2. Number 3, OHASD or agent spawn. MDNSD, used for DNS lookup. GIPCD, used for inter-process, inter-node communication. GPNPD, grid plug and play profile daemon. EVMD, event monitor daemon. ASM resource for monitoring ASM instances. Okay. Level 4, CRSD spawn. What are root agent? Agent is responsible for managing all root owned CRSD resources, or agent responsible for managing all the Oracle owned CRSD resources. Okay, level 4, CRSD root is spawns. Network resources, time to monitor the public network, scan VIPs, single client access virtual IPs, node VIPs, one per node, ICFS registry for mounting ASM cluster file system, GNS VIP option, VIP GNS. CRSD or root agent spawn. Then the CRSD or root agent is responsible for starting the rest of the resources as follows: ASM resource, ASM instance and resources, disk group used for managing monitoring ASM disk group, DB resource used for the monitoring and managing the DB and instances, scan listener for single client access name, listening of the scan VIP, listener, node listener, and listening on the node VIP, services used for monitoring and managing services, ONS Oracle notification service, EONS enhanced Oracle Notification Service, GST for Dynamic Background Compatibility, GNS optional, Grid Naming Service, Perform Name Resolutions. Okay. Here it is the, simply I showed you that all the Oracle cluster process resources. The following command will be displayed. CRSCTL status-t, this will show the all the resources, whatever resources available on the cluster nodes. So I have demonstrated here. Continue of the cluster resource. That is local resources. This is cluster resources. Okay. In this, I did not start up my DB database. I am just simply showing the clusterware processes only. Okay. Here, very important place this. Like we need to know the location by Oracle, the clusterware process log file locations. Clusterware daemon logs are all under CRS home log node name location. In my lab environment, the structure under Oracle home log name in alert log. Let me brief you about the logs below. In any clusterware issues, you need to look at these logs only. Okay. So this is a CRS log location. I went already. PWD U01 app Oracle Direct CRS Rack 01 CRS trace. You can see here, this is a diagnostic. If you need any problem in CRS, you have to look the CRS TRC and override root agent root TRC. Or as in Oracle TRC, and this two only you have to look it up, and also the CSST Oracle cluster synchronization daemon, this trace files. So this is Oracle high availability service daemon, this trace files. You have to look it out whenever having the issues in the rack cluster processes. Any issue as a node eviction or node failure, any issues, you have to look out that ASM alert log as well as CRS alert log and the CRS CSS OHS trace files, and then some more files, EBMD trace, event manager daemon, OCSS TSSD trace, alert log. This is alert log, CRS alert log. ASM location, this is a by default ASM location, ASM 1 and ASM 2. This is a locations. Okay, now yes, this is all about Oracle Clusterware startup sequence processes, and I hope you all understand what is happening and what is Oracle, how it is happening, the Oracle 12c clusterware startup sequence in this video, and I'm going to demonstrate that I'm going to stop the CRS and start the DRS CRS, and I will show you what is happening that. Okay, here you can see here node to node rack. Here I'm going to stop the CRS now. While stopping CRS, we need a root access. I'm stopping. We can see the trace files. Node 1 I am stopping, and again I need to stop node 2 once it is completed. Yes, the node 1 has been, CRS has been stopped successfully, and we will go to node 2. Here it is running on rack node 2 only, so I am going to stop it here also. I am stopping here also. Thank you. Okay, successfully stopped the CRS on the second node as well. Okay, we'll move to first node. Now we can check here, nothing is running on so it's not running. Okay, DNS. So nothing is run. Okay, we'll start that CRS and we'll watch that log. CRS CTL start CRS. Okay, now what is happening you can see here. So you can see first where it is. CSD agent starting operating system. So this one cluster is starting with that process. So you can see this what is happening. We have discussed. This is what we have discussed in that video. This is what happening in the background. Okay. Hope you guys will be understanding clearly on how it is happened Oracle RAC cluster with process initiating and startup sequence executed. So you can easily understand what is going on in the background. You can see here the CRS details start CRS. It is the Oracle IoT service domain has been started. You can see now d.bin. So it's checking the OCR file size. You can see what are the, this is that start one and it will go to this order and it will go to OCSSD and then OCSSD. This one and then OCSSD and then first it will go to OHSD bin and then CRSD and OCSSD and OCTSSD and then EBMD and then OCND bin and MDSND, GPNBD, CIPD. So like this order it will start. So that I have demonstrated in that you can see here. Now you can see MGMD listener, local listener and scan listener also started. Group PMO, you can see here MASM1 and MGMD DB has been started. CRSCTL start RAS-T. You can see rack node, everything will be started. Node 1, everything will be started and stable. Okay. Node 2, we need to start again here. CRSCTL start CRS. So while starting that third scan listener, you can see here this one. This is scan 1 or scan 3. Anyone will be relocated to node 2. You can see I will show you here later once it is startup completed. I will show you that also. CRSCTL check cluster -R. You can see it is track one. It is everything online. You can see here communication ready service is not yet started. It's under in startup process. It's going on, right? So once it is, it will take a few minutes to complete. Once it is completed, and then you can check all the cluster services will be online. Okay, now you can see here, I checked this service signal. This is another node as well. Everything will be online. Then we will check it out. Here at CTL, check state res -t. So you can see both the nodes up and running. Both the nodes is running. Now you can check that TNS also. One scan listener will be routed to node 2. TNS. I told you, right? Scan 1 will be routed to node 2. You go and check here. Okay. That's all, my friends. That's it. Once again, thanks for watching this video. Kindly subscribe Oracle F1 and we will see you in next video if any other interesting tutorial. Thank you.